Hello, my name is Elmira Louie, and I am double majoring in comparative literature and English and minoring in Spanish. The title of my research project is Sa'di and the Safavid, the Material Culture of a Treasured Persian Manuscript Now at UO. And this project was specifically for my last honors college colloquia that I took here at UO, and my mentor was Dr. Vera Keller. Now, what attracted me to this project is that this manuscript is hitherto unresearched, and so I really wanted to fill in this gap of knowledge by writing about the manuscript and specifically trace it back into its original historical and cultural context. And we know the date that this manuscript was produced. It was produced in 1615. However, we don't know the city within which it was created. So, my research project, through analyzing the material culture and the text, and also using other sources by manuscripts, was able to track down the city that it was produced. And so that was the biggest significant contribution that my project made, is to identify that this Persian manuscript that we have in special collections was actually created in Shiraz, Iran, in 1615 CE. This manuscript is part of the Burgess Collection in Special Collections, and it contains the combination of prose and poetry from the prominent Persian author Sa'di. Now, Sa'di is as well known and famous to Persians as Shakespeare is to us here in the West. So, our manuscript, before it was brought to Europe, was created in Persia in 1650. That places it during the rule of the Safavid dynasty that ruled Persia for over 2 centuries. But this dynasty highly valued arts and literature, and they embedded this within the fabric of Persian culture from then onwards. And significantly, each member of the royal court were not only patrons of the arts, but they also practiced it themselves. And Shah Tahmasp, who was the second Safavid ruler, actually established the first imperial workshops called Kitabkhane, where artists, illuminators, binders, and other specialists came together to create these deluxe manuscripts. And the Kitabkhane were really just this beacon where exceptional talent was drawn. Now, without the formal job application process that we have today, aspiring artists had to l rely on their natural talent to be recognized by local governors within the bazaar workshops. And these governors would hire these artists and then, in turn, offer them up to the Shah in hopes of currying favor. So, placement into the Kitabkhane relied heavily on a system of favors, cultural trade-offs, and just a little bit of luck. This manuscript is very special because, unlike most manuscripts that have coming out of Persia that have this leather-bound binding, this one is more European style with red velvet and silver clasps. And that's because at some point in its life, this manuscript was transported to Europe. And according to the bookseller's catalog entry, it actually once belonged to John Ruskin, who was a preeminent art theorist of Victorian England. The fact that this manuscript once belonged to Ruskin is further solidified because in his collections, Ruskin owned actually 7 other manuscripts that weren't Persian, but that were also rebound in very similar red velvet with silver clasps. And now Ruskin was not only a preeminent art theorist, but he was also an avid art collector, and also one of the leading figures of Orientalism. And so this really highlights the Orientalist past that our manuscript contains, and which can be visibly seen today with its European-style binding. However, despite the Orientalist past that it comes out of, Ruskin was very important to this manuscript and Persian manuscripts in general because he brought back the importance of the ornamental borders. Because every single page of our Sa'di manuscript is beautifully decorated with these Islami style blossoms and intricate interlacing shapes and geometric designs. And this design can be seen in a lot of other artworks, such as Persian carpets. But each page of our manuscript not only has these designs, but also is interlaced with gold and very other precious and highly valuable material, such as lapis lazuli. The Islami blossoms, that which is the intricate flower and leaf designs that are on the borders surrounding the pages of this manuscript, these symbolically nod to the literal meanings of Bustan, which is a garden, and Golestan, which is a place of flowers. And many critics have also noted that the Islami style is much like a visual and aesthetically pleasing poetry of its own. So it's important to note that when these words on the page were read, they were not only read just, you know, the simple calligraphy, but also the images and the Islami drawings that border it as well. They all come together to produce the meaning. So when you have modern editions of Sa'di or editions of Sa'di translated into English, if you don't include this ornament that is in this, that was in the manuscripts, you essentially lose half of the meaning, because each page is so vibrant with these colors, and they actually do contribute a lot to the meaning of the words as well. The strongest indication that our manuscript was created in Shiraz comes actually from the calligraphy. Now, our Sa'di manuscript is written in a type of calligraphy called nastaliq. And so this is an elegant script commonly used by Shirazi scribes, and now has believed to have originated from Shiraz.